The sensational speed of the Drosera glanduligera snap tentacles becomes clearly visible if single frames of the movement are compared with those of the famous Venus flytrap, which is a genus of its own, but also a member of the sundew family Droseraceae. Without any doubt, this rapid catching for prey by a plant is very amazing for everybody watching it for the first time.
Snap, 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 tentacles. Snap, tentacles and run real ice. Snap, tentacles and run real ice. Snap, 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 tentacles.
Comparing the speed of Dionaea with Drosera glanduligera through video single pictures shows evenly matched opponents. The pictures are the 25th part of a second apart, so the movement during four pictures takes approx 1.5 tenth of a second, surprisingly for both plants. The correspondence of trigger hairs and tentacles was described by Professor Stephen Williams in his lecture for the ICPS in Tokyo 2002.
Now here's the trigger hair of the Venus flytrap. It shows that there's an endodermis here. And that's obviously homologous with this endodermis. So that means that the stylus up here on the trigger hair is homologous with the gland cells, and that the stalk cells are homologous with the podium here, including the sensory cells, which are right here in this notch. And so we can begin to see how it's related. And then really the Venus flytrap trigger hair is probably a highly modified tentacle.
Snap tentacles and run real ice. Snap tentacles and run real ice.
Most of the modern sundew seedlings develop powerful marginate tentacles of type 1 and 2, directly after the cotyledons, just like this sundew from the Philippines. Especially with such seedlings, the basic morphology of these plants can clearly be seen under a microscope. This alternation of type 1 and 2 tentacles becomes more complicated with adult leaves, which develop different, more or less sophisticated patterns depending on the species. In our opinion, until now, an underestimated distinctive feature that deserves more attention for systematics. Snap tentacles are obviously very beneficial for seedlings and basal rosettes, as only the erect growing Drosera, which catch mainly flying insects, exchange the type 2 snap tentacles with mucus-producing stalked glands during maturity. Just like this Drosera binata. The seedling shows powerful snap tentacles, but as soon as the leaf starts to split into the typical adult form, only stalked glands are produced. One interesting exception to this pattern is made by the unique Drosera glanduligera. After the cotyledons, the seedling develops firstly leaves with the sticky type 1 marginal tentacles. Type 2 tentacles never appear. After that, some of the tentacles show an intermediate state, somewhere between type 1 and type 3. And only after some 3 to 4 leaf generations, the first fully developed type 3 tentacles grow, which function as rapid snap traps. Regarding this ontogenetic development, Drosera glanduligera seems to be, phylogenetically speaking, the oldest of the modern Drosera, despite the fact that it possesses the most sophisticated snap tentacles.